All right, let's get started. Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, everyone. Thank you all for joining in. Welcome to the first webinar in the Freshservice ITOM webinar series. This is Ram from Freshservice product team. Today, we will be covering how to integrate your monitoring tools with Freshservice alert management. We are also joined by Naganandini and Anusha from Freshservice product team. So if you have any questions during the demonstration, please feel free to post your questions on chat. Either we'll answer them after the end of the session or we'll answer them then. Let's quickly switch to the demonstration.
Hello, everybody. Thanks for joining the session today. I'm Naganandini and I'm a senior product manager in Freshservice. I currently work on the IT operations module. With the introduction of IT operations management and especially with that of alert management, you're bringing the ability to track and manage your alerts from multiple sources and also provide your DevOps and IT ops teams and unified platform to collaborate and react to incidents in a timely manner. So today I'll walk you through how you can actually leverage the best of both the worlds and manage your alerts and incident lifecycle within Freshservice. So to start with, I'll briefly give an overview about the benefits of using Freshservice alert management to track and manage your infrastructure health, and also an end-to-end overview of how the feature works. Then I'll switch to the key focus of today's session, which will be a demo on how you can integrate your monitoring tools. For this, I'll pick two tools. One tool for which we have a pre-configured setup done for you in Freshservice. Two will be a custom integration. I'm going to show you how you can basically integrate with any tool of your choice by giving you a step-by-step walkthrough of how you can go about integrating. So if you have any questions, please feel free to add it on the chat window. My team will either handle it then and there, or I'll take it towards the end of the session. All right, so let's get started with looking into the benefits of using alert management in Freshservice. So as you all know, the biggest pain point that an ops agent faces on a daily basis while monitoring is having to go through hundreds and hundreds of notifications coming from different monitoring tools, and that too in a disjointed manner. So they get notified on multiple channels, they have to switch portals, and this only gets worse during a service disruption because they get flooded with notifications from all the interconnected devices. And it also takes a long time for them to get to the underlying issue. So the information, as you know, is scattered across different monitoring tools, and it just becomes difficult to connect the dots if there's an interdependent service disruption. So this is where Freshservice helps you to do the job better. Freshservice serves as a single pane of glass to triage information from multiple tools, and it is also easy to set up your integrations via a webhook. Through alert grouping, agents can actually cut through the noise and get to the bottom of the issue quickly. There's also automatic incident creation, which is based on the incoming alert properties, and it helps you route to the respective agent groups for quick resolution without any manual intervention here. This will actually serve as a unified tool for managing your alerts and incidents, so you can just do away with the siloed on-point solutions here. You also have automatic CI association to incidents so that you can quickly do a root cause analysis and understand what is the impact of the issue, right? So let me give you an overview of how this works before I show you the feature. So Freshservice allows you to seamlessly integrate with multiple monitoring tools and triage all your information in one place. The incoming alerts are then automatically grouped to help you cut through the noise and quickly get to the bottom of the issue. And on resolution of the issue in the monitoring tool, the issue gets automatically resolved in Freshservice as well. You can also set up alert rules to create actionable incidents and notify your team to begin immediate resolution. All right, so let me give you a demo of how to set up the integration with your monitoring tools. So when you log into your Freshservice agent portal in the admin section, you can see a module called IT Operations Management. First, you need to start with creating an alert profile. An alert profile is basically a logical grouping of alerts coming from one or more monitoring tools. So let's say you have a service-oriented architecture and you're using different tools to monitor the health of each of those services. Then you can go ahead and create an alert profile and integrate the tools that are responsible for monitoring each of the services. So let me go ahead and name the alert profile. Once you do this, the next step is to integrate the tools that are responsible for monitoring the service. So I click on Add Integration here. And once I do that, you can see a list of monitoring tools here. So basically, you can integrate with n number of monitoring tools that are monitoring the service. And you can see a list of both on-prem and cloud infra tools here. In Freshservice, we have actually pre-configured the setup for some of the popular monitoring tools. And for these tools, we also provide you with an instruction guide on how the webhooks have to be configured in the monitoring tools. But it does not restrict you to just integrate with these tools. You can also do a custom integration with any tool of your choice. So for today's demo, I'm going to show you how the custom integration is different from the pre-configured setup that we have here. I'll start with creating a custom integration with a tool named AppOptics. So AppOptics is basically a powerful infrastructure and application performance monitoring tool. Before I get started with the integration, let me first explain the flow here. So there are two steps here overall. The first part is the configuration, which is done in Freshservice in order to normalize the incoming alerts coming from the monitoring tool so that you can group, filter, and report on the values in the alert payload. And then the next step is the configuration, which is done in the monitoring tool, where you'll be provided with an endpoint URL and an auth token, which needs to be configured in the monitoring tool. Right, so to get started with, you need to first copy the alert payload, which is sent from the monitoring tool. Generally, it should be available in your monitoring tool's documentation page, or in case you already have an existing alert and you know the alert payload structure, you just have to copy paste it in a JSON format here. So I'm referring to AppOptics documentation page for that. And I have a sample payload like this. All I need to do is just copy it and paste it here. I click on save and next. Now in the next screen, what you have to do is map the alert fields which are present in the payload, which is sent from AppOptics to the Freshservice fields. So before we do that, let me explain what these fields are. The resource field denotes the name of the entity or the device that you're actually monitoring. The metric name denotes the performance aspect of the device that you're monitoring. For example, if it's a server, let's say it's a CPU utilization, the throughput that you're monitoring here. The rest of the fields are pretty self-explanatory here. In the tags field, you can actually map up to 5 alert fields here. In the additional info field, you can also map up to 5 fields. The occurrence time denotes the time when the alert was actually created in the monitoring tool. So let me do the mapping. When you hover over these fields, you can see a plus icon here. When you click on this, you can see the alert fields, which was just extracted from the previous screen, and you can just map it here. So once I click on save and next, in the next screen, I'll be doing the severity mapping. Severity basically denotes the urgency of an incoming alert notification. So we have different severity levels in Freshservice for which you have to map the equivalent severity levels from the monitoring tool. Some of the monitoring tools do not support this concept of severity, but what we have done here is we have actually pre-configured the list of severity levels across different monitoring tools. In case if you do not find this mapping meaningful, you can go ahead and edit it, or you can remap it. All you have to do is just type a free text here, which maps to the equivalent of Freshservice severity level. So the reason why we actually do this is to enable auto closure of the issues within Freshservice. When a monitoring tool sends an equivalent of what maps to the OK severity in Freshservice, the alert gets automatically resolved here. So what this actually means is when the issue gets resolved in the monitoring tool, the alert also gets automatically resolved in Freshservice. So again, you'll have to refer to the documentation to understand the severity levels. So in this case, let me show you how I found that. Here, this monitoring tool is sending another payload for cleared alert. If you notice, the only difference in the payload is actually this particular field value. So in the previous screen, I have actually mapped the key clear to Freshservice severity. So any value which is present in this will be mapped here. In case if the monitoring tool does not send an equivalent for critical error or warning, by default, all the notifications which are received in Freshservice will be created with severity warning. Now that I've mapped it, in the last screen, all I have to do is copy the endpoint URL and the auth header in order to configure it in the monitoring tool. So let me show you how that has to be done. Again, going back to the documentation page here. So this is how a webhook configuration has to be done in this particular tool. It is going to vary from one tool to another. In case if you have any difficulty in figuring out how the webhook URL has to be configured, you can always reach out to us and we'll do the research for you and help you configure it in the monitoring tool. As you can see here, for this particular tool, you'll have to click on the notification service, go to settings and copy the URL which was provided here. You'll have to make sure that the settings are first saved in Freshservice before you configure it in the monitoring tool. Okay. So for today's demo, I've already done the configuration in the tool and I'm going to now simulate alerts from this monitoring tool. So once the integration and the configuration is done in both Freshservice and also in AppOptics, the next thing that I'll do is click on the alerts icon here. And this will give me a list of all the alerts that are created in the system. So I'm going to now simulate sending some alerts into the system. As you can see, there's an incoming alert notification. Now I'm going to refresh this. So the first alert notification, which comes from the monitoring tool, creates an alert record within Freshservice. And every other notification, which comes for the same issue with a unique combination of resource and metric name, will be grouped under the same alert record in Freshservice. I'll show you how that works. I'll go ahead and simulate some more alerts. The second alert is also grouped under the same one. If you notice, the status of the alert continues to be in open because the severity is still in warning, but the moment you get a notification which maps to the equivalent of OK severity in Freshservice, the alert will get automatically resolved. As you can see, the alert is now resolved, and that's because you've received a notification with OK severity. So this is how the custom integration works. Let me now show you a demo of how we can set up an integration with a tool which we have a pre-configured setup done for you. You can see how it's different. Now Now I'm going to go ahead and pick one of the tools here, let's say New Relic APM. As you can see, the alert payload is already configured for you here. So this is the default payload which is sent from New Relic. All you have to do is just click on Save and Next. In the next screen also, the alert fields are already mapped for you. You can just quickly review it in case you do not find it relevant to you, or if you want to go ahead and modify that. All you have to do is just hover over these fields, you'll see the plus icon. When you click on it, you can click on any of the fields here and that will replace the existing field names that you see here. Right, so then click on Save and Next. Again, the alert severity is also mapped for you. So with the pre-configured setup, all you have to do is just quickly review and move on to the next screen to configure the authorization in the monitoring tool. So you're also provided with the endpoint URL and auth header. Additionally, you're provided with a link with an instruction, which is an instruction manual for how you have to configure the endpoint URL in New Relic. So these steps give you that information. So I already have a New Relic account where I have created a notification channel for this. Now I'm going to show you the configuration. I'm going to copy this. Make sure you save the integration and fresh service before you actually save the integration and test sending an alert from New Relic. Let's save the integration here. Now I'm going to New Relic and I'm going to try sending a test alert to see if this works. As you can see, we got a 200 response for this. Go back to fresh service to see the New Relic alert. It's coming from New Relic here. Click on it. Right, so this is a test alert which was sent from New Relic. So as you can see, the process is very simple to set up. When the integration is pre-configured within fresh service, all you have to do is it's just a few clicks away for you to complete the integration in the monitoring tool also. So this is how simple it is for you to integrate your monitoring tools with fresh service and track and manage your alerts here. Additionally, I would also like to touch upon the alert rules. So what alert rules basically does is it allows you to specify conditions based on the incoming alert properties, so that you can automatically create incidents and also do an action on these incidents on creation itself. So let me show you how that works. I can show you an existing rule for that. So here, as you can see, there's a pre-configured alert rule for NagOS. What this means is once you get two critical severity alerts from NagOS consecutively, it will create an incident and it will automatically set the priority of incident as urgent. It will set the status to open and also add a private note to it on creation of the incident itself. So in this private note, you can go ahead and add some useful SOP links for your team to quickly resolve the issue. And on creation itself, you can see that it is automatically routed to the right team here. You can also add, set these properties on the incidents. And using ticket workflow automation, you can actually do more actions on this incident. These are the other alert properties on which you can actually create this. Let me show you one such scenario where an incident got created and you can see what information is actually added there. Let's take this alert. So as you can see, if the alert route is an enable state, when the incoming notifications come into the system, you can see that the incident also gets automatically created when the alerts come into the system. And let me click on that. So this is how an incident which got created from an alert role looks like. You can see that the source is set to alerts, and you'll have an alerts tab where the alert which spawned this incident will be associated to it. Click on this, you can see a history of all the group notifications here and how it has progressed over time. Along with that, based on the resource name in the alert, if you're actually tracking it in your CMDB today, based on the match with the resource name, if there's an asset with that same name, it will get automatically associated to this incident here like this. So this way you can understand the impact of the issue, and you can quickly work on your remediation steps. You also have analytics here where you can report on the volume of alerts that have been handled by your incident over a period, by your team over a period of time. You can also report on some of the alert fields that we have here. So that is pretty much what I wanted to show you. I believe that it kind of helps you to understand how to go ahead and integrate with any tool of your choice with Freshservice, or you know how to make use of the pre-configured setup that we have here. So let me quickly summarize what we just saw. Freshservice provides you with 15 plus popular out-of-the-box integrations with popular monitoring tools. And we're constantly working on adding more integrations to simplify the setup process for you. You can also integrate with any tool of your choice by using the webhook. And we're also working on introducing other means of integrating with your monitoring tools, like using email as a channel to integrate with the tools. By making use of the CMDB that we have in Freshservice, you can quickly identify the resource which is sending out the alert. You can understand the impact of the issue, and you can work on your remediation quickly. In case if you were to get stuck with the integration steps, you can always reach out to us, and we are more than happy to help you, you know, integrate with your monitoring tools. Thank you so much for attending this session. Now I think I can take the questions that you have for me. Okay, I see a few questions here. I'll go through it one by one. Okay, so what if we don't see IT operations management in admin section? Well, this feature is currently available in Pro and Enterprise plans of Freshservice. To log into your account as admin, you should be able to see it if you're in these plans. You can also reach out to the support team regarding this if you're in plans which is other than Pro and Enterprise. And when you upgrade to these new plans, there will not be any feature or data loss. And if you're still not able to see it when you're in these plans, which most likely should not be the case, we'll reach out to you to figure out what the issue is. All right, so moving on to the next question, how do we integrate with tools that do not trigger a webhook? Okay, so we are currently working on introducing the ability to integrate your monitoring tools via emails as well. Until then, you can send the alert notifications into the system as individual incidents by using our existing ability to create multiple email-based support channels. Yes, so that is that. And is there additional documentation on this that we can reference? In case if you're referring to alert management, yes. My team will share the support article links with you. And regarding the plan upgrades, the support team should be able to give you more information on that. For after hours alerts, is there any mechanism to audibly alert the agent? Well, we are currently working on introducing on-call schedules and escalation policies to determine the availability of agents round the clock. And in case if any alert comes during after hours, you can actually figure out which team have to be notified and the order in which you have to notify the agents in that team. And if one person is not available to attend to it, it will automatically get escalated to the next level of agents in that particular team. And not just that, we're also currently working on adding new channels of notification. It's not just going to be email, because since it is after us, it is important to notify the agents in a channel that they will immediately attend to. So we are adding the capability to notify agents via phone, SMS, Slack, etc. All right, next question. How long does alert grouping happen? Can you explain that more? Okay. The first alert notification, which is sent from the monitoring tool, it gets created as an alert record in Freshservice. We refer to each alert notification as an alert log here. When the monitoring tool sends multiple notifications for the same issue, we aggregate these notifications, or let's say we rather thread them to the same alert record in Freshservice. And we identify that it is the same issue using a unique combination of resource and metric names. And this grouping or the threading of these alerts, alert notifications, it will continue to happen until the Freshservice alert record goes to a resolve status. And once it goes to resolve status, if a new notification comes in for the same issue within a certain period of time, the same alert record will get reopened. If it comes after that period of time, then it will create a new alert record in Freshservice. It will be considered as a new issue. So this time period that I'm referring to, the reopen interval, it can be modified under alert profile settings. You should be able to see that there. By default, it is set to 30 minutes now. Can we integrate Freshservice with LAN Sweeper? We'll have to actually look into it. We can quickly go through the documentation and we can let you know how this can be done. So we'll get back to you on that. We would need pre-configured setup for a few monitoring tools that we use. How can you help us here? So like I previously mentioned, one, we'll go through the list of tools that you'll be sharing with us in this session to the Google form that we have given to you on the chat. And we'll try adding as many as tools as possible. We'll pre-configure the setup for these tools. And in case if you have missed adding it, please leave it in the chat now. Also, if you do get stuck up in the process when you do a custom integration, you can always reach out to us through the feedback button, which is there in alert profiles page, or you can write to us at support@freshservice.com and we reach out to you to help you, fix the issues. Okay. Any plans to add integration with IPS switch and WhatsApp Gold? WhatsApp Gold is definitely there on our list and we're looking into it. And like I mentioned, we are trying to add as many as, we're trying to actually integrate with as many as tools as possible. Meraki does not currently support custom headers with webhooks. Is there any other methods of authentication with Freshservice? Yes, we did notice that to be an issue. Today, we're actually giving them as two different, as an auth header and an endpoint URL. But there'll be a reason. I mean, there'll be a new enhancement which will be done this week. You should be able to see the option to see a query param with which you can actually integrate your tool. And we're also bringing in username and password options there. And also, like I mentioned, email is going to be another channel that we'll be supporting very soon in the future. So that should actually solve this problem. But we'll definitely, take a look at Meraki's documentation. We'll see how this issue can be solved and we'll write to you about, what are the steps you should be following to integrate with it. All right. How does it handle multiple alerts for the same asset? So the asset here is what we refer to as the resource, which is sending out the alerts. So as I mentioned earlier, let's take a server for instance. The server is sending out multiple CPU alerts, right? CPU being the metric name here. And the same server is also sending multiple throughput alerts, right? So in this case, what happens is we will create one alert record in fresh service, which will basically group all the notifications which is sent from the same server, which will be an aggregation of all the CPU utilization alerts, and then another record which will be an aggregation of all the throughput alerts. So that's how it works. And when an incident gets created through alert tool for these alerts, you can automatically see that if you are actually tracking this asset in your system, you can see it automatically get associated to the incident. So this association, it happens based on the name match. So if the resource name matches with the asset name in your CMDB, it will get automatically associated. All right. Where is the mention shared Google Doc link to add the monitoring tools? It's actually in the chat window. I'll ask my team to share it again if you do not see it. Yeah, you can just scroll a bit up and you should be able to see this link there. All right, I think I've pretty much answered all these questions. Thank you so much for joining. Over to you, Ram.
Hey, sure, Nandini. Thank you so much. Thank you for the walkthrough. And thank you all for joining in. So this is just the first webinar of the ITOM series. So we have other sessions on task management, orchestration center, and also we have another session on the alert smart grouping feature early next month. So if you haven't signed up for the entire webinar series, you can go over it right from here. I'll leave the registration form on the Zoom chat. Yeah, if you have any questions on the alert management feature, please write to us at support@freshservice.com. Our team would be able to get back to you on any assistance that you would need with integrating with monitoring tools or any assistance you need in terms of setting up alert rules or configuration. Okay, I see that you have answered most of the questions. Yeah, do write to us and we'll be sharing this recording for all the registrants. I'm looking forward to see all of you in the next task management ITOM webinar. Thank you so much. Have a great day.